Bystar Jesse Martinez. Jesse, how you been? You look in shape? You look focused?
I feel good. Kind of ate too much during fucking Christmas, but yeah, I'm back at it.
You're fighting at 47, 54 your next
147.
147. Yeah. You're a big 47.
Yeah, but no, I got my diet right. Working on getting it down a little bit more, and yeah, I'll be good.
Break down Broner Pacquiao. They're both in your weight class.
I think Pacquiao takes it. He's just legendary. He's going to be too fast for him. He's going to put combos together, and I feel like Broner's going to show us what he has showed us in these past fights. He'll probably land a couple punches on Pacquiao, but I think Pacquiao is just going to be over him.
Now, you're one of the few people I know that I've seen personally spar Floyd Mayweather. Uh-huh. Mayweather's in Japan right now. On December 31st, he has a big sparring session. He's going to get paid more than Wilder and Fury combined.
Damn.
For sparring a kid for nine rounds.
Yeah, I've seen that, an exhibition match.
Yes.
Right?
I just put A or I put Ellie Sengberg.
Whichever, you can do both.
It's a mess.
Put both, Brandon.
Yeah. It's a mess.
It's a mess. So what do you think about Floyd? You sparred him.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, I seen the other guy, and he's decent. He's good.
Very
as,
good. Attention.
He's good as a fighter, but
he's a kickboxer.
He's a kickboxer.
Legend out there.
Yeah, but I don't know.
What do you think he does? What's your prediction for this sparring session? Do you think Floyd stops him? Do you think he goes all 9 minutes?
Nah, he's just gonna. I think he's just gonna do what he's always done. He's gonna box and try not to get hit. But yeah, I don't know. It's only 4 rounds, right?
Three rounds.
A three rounds.
As far as I know. I mean, I may be wrong, but no judges, doesn't go on his record.
Damn.
What was it like for you to experience sparring Floyd? Do you still think about it sometimes, Jesse?
Yeah, I do. Like,
and what goes through your mind? Like, if you could spar Floyd, and tell me about the sparring. How long was it? How long was each?
It was 3 rounds, but his rounds were like, there was no timer, so just whenever he wanted to start and whenever he wanted to stop.
They're around 10 minutes around.
So if Jesse could hang for 10 minutes around with Floyd, he didn't stop you, he didn't drop you.
No.
Okay, so if he could be in Floyd, the best ever, ever, ever. What does that say about Jesse Martinez?
It says the world. I mean, it says that this is the level that this young champion is at.
I've seen him stop people in sparring. And you sparred with 300 people there. 299 were going against you.
Yeah.
Only one was in your corner.
It was a crazy environment. But yeah, I held my own in there, and it gave me a lot of confidence.
And now your record is what?
10-0, 7 knockouts.
What could we expect for 2019 for Jesse Martinez?
We were held up with an injury to the end of this year. Didn't get to be as active as we want. In 2019, it's promising to be. Look, that's the year that we become that person that the ring is talking about, that all the publications are talking
about.
Prospect,
oh, who's that.
Yeah, prospect / contender.
We got to be more active 2019, and we're going to step it up.
Okay, so let's go back to the sparring. You started to tell me. I'm sorry I cut you off.
Uh-huh.
You think about it sometimes. What do you think about you and Floyd in the ring?
It's just crazy to think you got in the ring with the best ever of this era. Probably, I don't know, just the best ever. And it just gives me a lot of confidence, because whenever I spar anybody else, I'll just remember, like, all right, I've been in the ring with Floyd, like, the best. So it just gives me that confidence.
You came to help him, and he's helping you years after it happened.
Yeah,
isn't that crazy?
Yeah. Like I said, it gave me so much confidence.
Look, and Floyd probably has some story in his head about how he sparred with so-and-so when he was
a
young guy.
Yeah.
I think it's a necessity for a champion to have that memory.
So, Brandon, you ever think you work a corner against Floyd Mayweather in sparring? Is that even an option?
It was a surreal driving there that evening.
Tell them the story how it happened. You were at home chilling with after 3 beers.
Three minimum.
Well, we know, like, you were driving, so I don't want to burn you.
It was like
10 o'clock at night, 10:45.
It was like 10:45. I was living kind of like in the hill. I didn't get good service. All of a sudden, who's calling me? Ellie Sekbak.
And you were going to send me the voicemail.
And I'm looking at my phone, and I'm looking at my beer, and I'm looking at my phone, and I'm looking at my beer, like on the very last ring. I'm like, all right, what is this? Better be good, man. Hey, what's up? You go, Floyd wants to spar. He's done it. And I go, ha, ha, ha. Yeah, bullshit, Ellie. All right, I'm going to go. And no, I'm dead serious, bro. It's Jesse went in. I'm like, oh, shit, this is real. And then, you know what? Instantly in my head, I was like, Jesse's in. But first off, I got to see if I have service that I can even get a hold of Jesse. And then if Jesse believes that I'm even telling the truth, because I like to fuck around a lot, right? So I can't. It's not calling him, so I have to text him, which makes it sound bullshit, right? And he's kind of like, yeah, right, whatever. And then finally, after a bunch of texts, he's like, okay, wow, I guess this is real. So we met here, like 15 minutes later. So now it's like 11 p.m. We grab our shit. We drive down to Tengu's Boxing. That's who was hosting it. And yeah, on the ride there, we're like, okay, when Floyd Mayweather, blah, 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 blah. Like, we come up with like a strategy of how to fight Floyd, which was very cool. And the strategy was basically like, Jesse, you got nothing to lose.
And then you come to the gym, you see hundreds, it's packed. It's like a sea of people.
No. You're not doing it justice. We get to Tengu's Boxing, and it's like a ghost town. It's you, it's Ricky, it's like a handful of people. Right. All right, this is a trip. And next thing you know, these caravans start showing up, all like TNT'd out, 20, everywhere. You got
20 Rolls Royces show up.
People just get down. Now this gym is packed.
And it's like 1 a.m. already, 12:30.
Yeah, it's like midnight now. And there's the champ. He's getting warmed up. And it's kind of weird. Nobody says nothing to us. Well, Sam Watson keeps coming up to us and going, is your guy in shape? Is your guy in shape? I go, yeah, he's in shape, man. Don't worry. But other than that, no one's really saying nothing to us. So I'm kind of like, there's other people with that look like they're there to spar. And then there's Jesse, right? And then Sam says, all right, you're going first. So they did say that to us, but nobody said like anything else. But then, so I'm keeping my eye on Floyd. And then finally, like, Floyd starts putting his shit on. I'm like, all right, so let's go put our shit on. So we get our stuff in. And dude, next thing you know, like, we're in the ring. There's just a sea of people everywhere around this gym. They're all talking shit. They're all talking shit, but like I didn't feel like I was going to get jumped or something.
No, it
was
like it's a all boxing. Fun. Yeah. No, and, very cool. Very good team. Very nice people. All of
next
that.
Thing you know, there Jesse's fucking trading blows with Floyd Mayweather, dude. Like having his guard. And Floyd is... This is Floyd getting ready for Andre Berto at the time. So this is totally Floyd's training camp. Like, good competitive sparring. And they're going at it, and 3 minutes goes by, 4 minutes, 5 minutes, 6 minutes, and like we had heard about this, so we half expected it. And Jesse's in there handling himself. Jesse's in there not getting whitewashed, not being the guy you hear about that gets Floyd flattened, in 3 minutes. Floyd is in there giving Floyd Mayweather. Jesse's in there giving Floyd Mayweather good work. And maybe 8-9 minutes in, they're going at it, and Floyd goes like this, and he turns around. And that means the round's over. Okay. So good. Jesse, come on. I get chance to like put water in Jesse's mouth, and Floyd goes, whoop. Okay, round's up. So we rest. So you box for like 10 minutes, but then you rest for like 15 seconds.
Yes. And sometimes, like I was helping a kid the other night, also Floyd was sparring. I couldn't even get his water bottle open. He had one of those smart water bottles. I guess I'm not smart enough, but the cap turned Swiss. I couldn't, and Floyd go, okay, no, didn't have water for 10 minutes in between because I was too slow. I felt so bad. Like, next time, just get a normal water bottle. They squeeze and water comes out. Not like you need a special code to open it.
Ellie, you're a rookie in the corner, my man.
Hey, but I've worked corners. I even work. You know what? I have a 1-0 as a coach in a professional fight. I helped some kid out. He knocked the opponent out in like 10 seconds. But I was in a corner. $50 and I'm a cornerman. Yeah. But that was a surreal thing. And then after you guys took a picture with Floyd, I think I took it.
Yeah.
It was very friendly. And here's the thing. Not everybody would pick up the phone. Not everybody would say, I'm available. Not tonight. We're tired. Maybe next week. When you get a call like that, I'm going. You never know what's going to lead to. What if Floyd was so impressed he would sign you that night?
No, what is the saying? That the luck is really just being able to take advantage of an opportunity that presents itself, you know? That's really it is.
But you have to be in that position. Like, if you were in bad shape and he would have stopped you in 2 minutes... Good that Brandon does a lot of strength and conditioning.
And you need to step out of your comfort zone.
Yeah, and you guys did it.
Dude, that was scary as fucking shit. Who wanted to win far and smart? This guy said yes. This guy's like, fuck yeah, let's go.
What were you doing when you got the call? Were you sleeping?
I was sleeping, yeah.
So he you could have been like, do you ever screen his calls? You're like, yeah, fuck it. Let me just send him the voicemail.
No, he called me first, but I slept through the call. Yeah. And I woke up to the text.
I would not wake up to a text. Would you wake up to a text message?
Nah, man.
Would you wake up to a text?
7 calls.
Depends how many beers I drink.
I don't wake up with my dog barking. How am I going to wake up to that text message?
I got lucky that I did wake up.
Yeah, it was meant to be. So there you have it. Jesse Martinez, a big 2019. Brandon Krause. So now you had a chance to be in the ring against Mayweather. Gervonta Davis is stepping it up.
Yes.
All right. Stay tuned. Jesse, where do people follow you?
You can follow me at Jesse the Magician on Instagram.
Jesse the Magician.
Coach Brandon Krause.
And here is... We need to update the poster, though, because that's the old nickname.
Yeah.
El Mago, which is in Spanish, short for magician.
The magician. Yeah.
Magnifico?
Magician.
El Mago.
El Mago is just the magician?
Yeah.
Israel Vasquez was what?
El Magnifico.
Which is what?
Magnificent.
Oh, okay. I'm not fluent in Spanish yet. For Eastern Reporting, that comes in by reporting.